fine fragrance olfactive families. The fine fragrance market seems to be very complicated. Every year, a lot of products are launched on the market, and that seems to be very confusing. We have a way to classify those launches in families. We classify them in six families. Three of those families are what we call realistic. That is a link with painting, you know, because those families, they will remember you of raw material or to something you can meet in your day-to-day life. It will be the citrus family, those perfumes, they will be dominating by a smell of citrus. When you first smell them, citrus will come to your mind. We will see examples like Eau Sauvage, like CK Wine, like Acqua di Gio for men. Second family will be the floral family. When you smell those products, the first thing that comes to your mind, it is flower. It could be one flower, or it will be a general flower, you know, like what we call floral bouquet. In that family, we will see a lot of feminine success. We will see examples like Chanel No. 5, like J'adore from Christian Dior. Usually, they are success for female products and not for men products. Another family, realistic family, will be the woody family. Of course, when you smell those products of that family, then the first thing that will come to your mind, that it will remember you of a wood. And then we will see examples like Féminité du Bois, like Vétiver from Guerlain, or like Terre d'Hermès. So that were the three realistic families. Then we've got three other ones that have been completely invented by perfumer. It is the Chypre family. Chypre, in English, you say Cyprus. It comes from the island of Cyprus. And it comes also from a very famous perfume created by François Coty in 1917. Since that time, we call a Chypre a perfume that has been built on that architecture. Today, you cannot buy any more Chypre de Coty. It's not on the market anymore. But we have some famous ships that we will see together, like Mitsuko from Guerlain or Aromatic Elixir. And then what we call modern ships, we are more floral, more fruity, and less dark. And then we will see Coco Mademoiselle and Narciso from Narciso Rodriguez. Another family very important, especially important for men, it is the fougère family, fern family. We will see that a lot of products, you know, are men's products, men's success, come from that family. A very famous one, especially in England, was Brut from Fabergé. And more recently, later on, we had products like Paco Rabanne for men, Cool Water, Polo Blue, and also Le Mal from Jean-Paul Gaultier, or Fierce for Men. They are all, you know, fougères and very successful. And the last family that we will see will be the Oriental. What we call Oriental, it is something where you can perceive something soft, something a bit like vanilla, vanillin-like. And usually those products, they are very comfortable, very sensual, very long-lasting. We will see examples like the old Shalimar. Then we will smell also Obsession from Calvin Klein. And of course, Angel from Terry Mugler, that we describe as Oriental as a main family and Gourmand as a subfamily. So with those six families, you can describe all the market and you can classify all the market.